This video serves as an Asset MSP Administrator portal overview. We will cover the functionalities of the portal, demonstrate creating a new customer and license management. First, we need to log into the portal. The account is created by a distributor and it automatically works as Asset Business Account. Here we have our Aquarius MSP partner that we'll be working with. The default view after logging in is the dashboard section. There is a welcome window showing tips on what to do, and of course the overview graphs, status overview for companies and users, and for the licenses. Here you can see the number of active ordered licenses, overused licenses, which means the administrator is using more than they should and they can adjust the quantity of these, suspended and expired licenses. Trend line for Unilicense and products is showing the progress in time, and at the bottom there is the real-time product usage and RSS feed. The License Management tab shows the created companies or customers and their licenses and allows the administrator to manage them in a very easy way. The Fruits company has products with various numbers of licenses. Asset Endpoint Antivirus for Windows, which is okay. There are 150 units available with 0 activated on any computer. For Asset Endpoint Antivirus for macOS, there is a trial license. The admin can easily see its validity. Asset Endpoint Encryption has a suspended license. This way, it's not active and it is not billed. There are various options for each license. Admin can see the daily usage graph and, of course, export it as a CSV file. There is a Show License History option, where you can see the changes made in time. As in this example, there is a time of ordering the license, and we see there was an update for license unit quantity. The admin has the option to upgrade the product and can easily choose from the offered bundles. Adjusting the license unit quantity is very easy, either up or down. The admin can raise or lower the quantity of specific license units whenever they need to. There are special options for trial licenses. Administrator can convert the trial license to a full one or can extend the trial period. A suspended license can be unsuspended with one simple click. The same goes the other way. When the administrator doesn't need the licenses, they can suspend them. The Companies tab offers the administrator a simple overview of their customers. There are a few options for the created company. The admin can see its details, add a user that can manage the company, edit its details, and suspend the whole company with all its licenses. In the company details, we can see its description, status, and available products. Access rights show the administrators with access to this company. Activated units show the number of license units activated on computers. Licenses tab shows the licenses for this company. The admin can do all the operations that were described earlier in the License Management tab. That means view the daily usage, license history, update the quantity, and so on. License usage shows the graph with active licenses. The administrator can generate the graph for a selected time period and, of course, export it. When creating a new company, the admin should name the company and select the products that will be available to it. In this scenario, it will be the company Pets. Products can be sorted by name, operating system, components, or list of available bundles or standalone products. We will choose 10 license units of Asset Protect Entry Bundle, which contains Asset Protect, Asset Protect Cloud, Asset Endpoint Security, and Asset File Security. 50 units of Asset Cloud Office Security, 10 times Asset Lifeguard Advanced, and from the standalone product, we'll take 50 trial licenses for Asset Endpoint Antivirus for Linux. There are no other administrators, so we won't assign any user to this company. Some products, as in this case, Asset Lifeguard Advanced, may require an agreement with the terms of use. Now the company is created and the licenses are ordered. The dashboard section is now offering an easy way to activate Asset Protect Cloud and Asset Cloud Office Security, as there were licenses for both of them ordered for the newly created company. After pressing the Activate option, there is the Data Center Location option and Agreement Acknowledgement. When activated, the new tab will appear among others. These newly created tabs can then serve as a shortcut to ECOS or Asset Protect Cloud. The Reports tab allows the administrator to generate license usage reports, either for all companies or for a few selected ones. The report can be generated for a specific time period and of course exported as a CSV file. User management shows the administrators. Here we can see John Smith, with write access to the company. This is our account. Creating a new user requires providing the name and email address to which they will receive the invitation. In this scenario, it will be Mark West. He will receive an activation email to his mailbox, he'll set up a password, and he's ready to work. There are three access rights levels: write access to the MSP company and all customers, read access to the MSP company and all customers, and no access to the MSP company with custom read or write access to customers. We will select no access to an MSP company and specific access to companies Fruits and Pets. It all depends on the MSP company needs. Local administrator for selected customers may not need the access rights to MSP company and may need only the access to those customers he or she is managing. There are special options for ECOS and Asset Protect Cloud when they are available, so the admin can choose what level of access the new administrator will have. Now we will log out of the portal, log in as Mark West, who is already activated. A local administrator with no access to the MSP company and custom access to selected customers. The default view is again the dashboard panel with information about the managed companies. Write privileges allow the admin to do all the things mentioned before. We can see here that the read privileges only give the admin an overview of licenses without any option to adjust the numbers of license units or requesting or managing them at all. The same goes for companies. Read access allows to see an overview, and write access means full management. When logged back as the main administrator for the MSP company, my Company tab is showing the details of the MSP company, like contact information or available products. In the Access Rights, there are administrators with right access to manage the MSP company. It is not showing the current administrator, and since Mark West has no access, the field is empty. License usage shows all the licenses in use by all customers. The admin can select the time period, choose the specific licenses, or select them all and generate the report, and of course export it as a CSV file. Audit log tracks various events that occur, like logins, authentications, alerts, and so on. The settings section has options to notify the admin when the license is close to overusage and to deactivate disconnected devices. After a selected time period, the devices not connecting to an asset MSP administrator will be automatically deactivated and the license seeds will be available for other devices. In the upper menu, there are notifications, links to various web pages when help is needed, and account settings. Here you can also find the two-factor authentication option. The Asset MSP Administrator portal is integrated with Asset Secure Authentication and so offers the option to tighten the security when logging in. During the next login, the system will offer a way to install the application for two-factor authentication. After installing a mobile application and scanning the QR code, the admin will have to enter the generated one-time password to log into the console. This concludes the Asset MSP Administrator overview. Thank you for watching.